Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
All right, welcome back from that break. Well, in case you're just joining us, you are watching Game On, and certainly many thanks for us being a part of the show Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, as we are inspired by 1xBet. But before the break, we're talking a bit of Paul. There is a newly, elected president. He comes with the whole executive committee as well. And that being said, let's have a quick look at the new Paul Association Uganda Executive Committee that has certainly, been put into place. That should be coming up in just a bit. But the confirmation is that the president, Bob Trubish, certainly does get to retain his role as, the president of the association, regardless of the issues. But there you go. That is the chairman, Mr. Bob Trubish. His vice chairman is Robert Kayanja. The tournament secretary happens to be Ismail Kalibala. The treasurer for the Paul Association is David Mugabe. Peter Chove happens to be the publicity secretary. Fauzia Namuganza remains the ladies secretary. And then Simon Kiria will be in charge of the schools and institutional secretary as well. So that is the leadership when it comes to the sport that is Paul. Quickly, guys, Faith, the conversation continues, and everyone is wondering, what is the way forward now? Are there structures to get rid of some of the issues they've had?
Of course, that has all been put in place. One thing I did observe when I was at that elective assembly was that people were actually kind of scatting, fearing to take up positions again at the association. I don't know, maybe because they were fearing that people would come after them on a personal note.
Yeah.
It was actually, for me, a little bit disappointing. But then at the end of the day, when you're put under pressure, the right people always come to the forefront, because there are positions where people had to literally be nominated on the floor.
Yeah.
Like, I just sit there and I say, Brian, I'm nominating you. And people are like, let's second and let's vote and all that stuff. That's how it was. But the truth is, the most important thing for the association at the moment is making sure the National Open comes back, because that is like the grand slam of everything in pool in Uganda. And without that, they always felt like last year, because the sponsor did not come back, they could not hold it. And it's very dependent on the sponsors. I know they are very, they insist on that particular sponsor. But me, I am of the view that they should think outside the box. If one beer brand is pulling out, why don't you look towards the next beer brand? Because at the end of the day, people buy 4 beers to enter the National Open.
Yeah, okay. Quickly, as we wrap this conversation up, Sharon, this is not, it's not just Paul, but so many federations have actually been through this kind of scenario. What is the way forward for sports in Uganda? Paul as an example.
First of all, given the story in the backyard as before we came back on air here, is that I come to realize that Trubish's re-election coming back into office was that he was impeached, maliciously,
yeah,
because probably you call it jealousy of people who think probably it's too much money. And this is a gentleman who is holding such a high-profile office in the country, working with Centenary Bank, being the head of public relations, human resource in the whole country. And then Paul doesn't have so much money. The association itself doesn't have so much money. We saw even when they were going for the African Games, they were crying for fundings to come here and there. So if you have a gentleman or a lady of that nature who is willing and ready to put in even Paul from their own pocket, and then you have these people who have their own selfish interests, is a very big problem. Now, to make a long story short a little bit, is that we have so many people who are very selfish in this country, who always envy and look at the other person, that why is so-and-so in that office, why is so-and-so benefiting so much, that I think onotumujewo ochitegera. But even when facts come out to find out that this person is innocent, the world still doesn't believe. Now, she has put in a very critical point here, that why should Paul rely on a Nile special. There are other so many corporate companies there. Pool is a corporate game. It's a game that brings people together. It's a very friendly game. I remember when I was in Paida, I used to watch it so much. In fact, yeah. I even started learning playing pool. If I had more trainers, I think today I would have been one of a good players of pool today. Now, the challenges we are facing here today is that how many competitions can we put on board? Yeah. Okay. So for the rest of the sports federations that are going through, we need structures on board. Structures that can help us actually bring money.
Yeah.
Because sports has money, but how are you going to look for that money? Two, if I try to look at the administrative bit of it, the structure, I'm seeing only one lady on board. So today, I want to tell you that so many corporate companies and organizations in the world would want to give you money. The first thing they will ask you, what is the position of women in that, you know, in that institution?
Mm.
Now, these corporate companies will say, now, we are also following what the standard UN is giving us, the standard the country is giving us. So if females are very few, these are some of the factors that are chasing away, probably would be sponsors. So we should also look outside the box, how we could fit that would bring these sponsors on board.
All right, there you go. That is Paul for you. But quickly, away from that, let's talk a bit of football right now, because like I mentioned at the beginning of the show, the Uganda Cup action does get to return later this evening. But quickly, for Mbara City, that a 2-1 win against Kakira United to progress into the round of 32. And there's plenty of football to look ahead to. And goals coming through from Ahewa and Okwalinga to put them a place in the next round. Sharon, for Mbara City, there's new management at the club. So many changes have come through. What do you make of the team as they move into the next round?
Well, probably, I think, first of all, Kakira United seem to be a very weak team from Mbarara City. Probably, I saw the goal mileage was a little bit too low compared to what I expected. However, Mbarara City just had a very big challenge, because the previous time they had just played against a team in Eastern Region, in Busoga itself, in Uganda Premier League. So they had to push their fixture a little bit forward. So you would think also maybe fatigue is one of the factors that probably led to the little small goal mileage. Going away and beating a club like that is not something very easy. But even given the fact that Brian Senyonyo, me, I think initially, the president of the club, Honorable Mwine Mpaka, had rushed, first of all, to sack this young gentleman. If he was given a chance from word go, he would be better off, like the way you think Arsene is doing with Arteta. Slowly, results are coming. So, but I think he's one of the Ugandan coaches that I would love to admire. I would love to see him progress.
Yeah.
And you see the style of play. You even watch the game against KCC in UPL. You would see, even if KCC won that game, but they struggled to get that win. So if Mwine Mpaka really totally gives an independence of an institution to this coach and the new management, then definitely Mbarara City is going to take it so high.
Faith, as we move on from Mbarara City, they've had changes in terms of management. You know, they lost Paul Mucherezi as well. They've battled against the drop. What do you think they'll be finishing juggling all these tournaments for the rest of the season?
You know, for me, when a team is, like, say, most importantly, like, struggling, not necessarily on the pitch, but also like in management and all that stuff, I think a lot of football is not what you need.
Yep.
You need to be concentrating on one competition and getting the best out of it. But then again, you cannot necessarily, you know, run away from things like the Uganda Cup. It's important at the end of the day. If you can juggle, good for you. But I would like to see how far Mbarara go with that, you know, juggling act.
All right, quickly, let's have confirmation of the round of 64 fixtures when it comes to the Uganda Cup, because tell you what, action does get returned later this particular evening. And there you go. Kato United should be hosting Poli. That should be down in Lugogo. Meanwhile, for Starlight, they'll be at home against Toro United. Chiriandongo TC will be up against the Kigezi Homeboys. As you also look at some of the other fixtures, look out for Kajansi United host Vipers. That promises to be quite an exciting one there. And Entebbe Road Derby, Busia Young will be up against Busoga United. Bogamba will take on Onduparaka as well. Another exciting one there for the fans of the Green Army. And then action returns on Thursday with Koboko Rising Stars up against Bright Stars. AC Villa will travel to the Super Eagles in the north. Maroons will be away to the Young Elephants. 6 o'clock, yes, all the way from the west down there. Will be up against
Chitara. I love the name of the
Kampala University will be hosting Kataka. Gagaba will be up against Chivoga Young. Those are some of the games on Thursday.
Is it Chivoga Young Ballet Heroes or Chivoga Young?
Well, we'll get Chivoga Young itself. And then on Friday, the Movra Boys host ball. KCCA take on Katida. That should be at the Chira Playground. And Lugazi Municipal will be up against URA. Soroti will be hosting Kansai Plascon. Yamitobora will be away to Chimpanzee. Firefire will be hosting Light Aces. And Deje will be away to FHL. Oh, and finally, the Freestars will take on the Saviors. Those are some of the games to look out for on Friday. And then over the weekend on Saturday, Admin host Police, Waxo Giants away to Bugoigo. San Siro will be up against Chetume. Mbale Garage will be up against UPDF. And then finally on Sunday, as I said, Mary's will be hosting Express. Kigezi will be up against Bukedea Town Council. New Villa will be on the road against Dav. Gaddafi will take on MYDA. UTouch will be at home against Water. Dav All Stars will take on Luwero United. And finally, the Spartans will be hosting Paida Black Angels. So there you go.
My that interest is Paida Black Angels Spartan.
For you. And quickly, Anta spoke about some of those games. You know, big teams, KCCA, Vipers, AC Villa in there as well.
And Paida Black Angels.
And Paida Black Angels, if you want, if it makes you feel better.
And 6 o'clock.
not making me feel better, but it's one of the big sides we'll talk about because I actually told Tendo Nickton Soke, who happens to be one of the directors of Spartans Football Club. I told him I have watched Paida Black Angels play quite a number of games at Barokoro, the home of Paida Black Angels in Paida Town Council, Zumbo District. It's one of the grounds you don't just go and pick points and come back with them. Well, the only difference is that the fans are not violent; they are okay without as long as the results is free and fair by the referee, no problem. So with Spartan, I don't expect Spartan actually to come back with a win there. However, anything is possible because apparently ever since Paida was got relegated out of Uganda Premier League, they've been struggling a little bit. Most of the big stars going away from Paida Black Angels. Look at the worst was one of the best defenders with Villa right now. And then so many of things. But being the fact that they're at home and they have not played so many games in FUFA Big League, you expect a lot. And then of course, Villa going to Gulu, playing in Gulu. One thing I would love to tell Villa is that Pecha is a very good ground, yes.
Yeah.
But just like those Acholi team, apparently Acholi is craving to have a team coming from that region. So any team that is whether in Uganda Premier League or in a regional league or probably in Uganda Cup like this one, they're going to put up a very spirited fight, and I know how Acholis are. So if the kind of performance, probably the only advantage that Villa has is that the win against Vipers at Chitende is a very good moral booster for the boys. But it all depends on how the coach will be tactical with the team. But for the rest of the clubs like KCCA, for me, I expect KCCA is going to have a good run. Despite the
Vipers, Kajansi,
Entebbe. Vipers, that one is going to be a hard one.
Yeah.
Actually, there's another fix I didn't talk about is Katwe United Proline.
Yeah,
that is
Proline, the reigning champions.
The reigning champions.
Yeah.
I don't know. Alan Sewanyana will do what honorable Alan Sewanyana will do whatever it takes to see that he wins against Proline at Rugogo. But the Entebbe Road Derby.
Yeah.
I don't know what I just don't know what Vipers is gonna do, but it's gonna be a very tough game because I've seen these boys. It's a well organized side, of course. Norbert Kazibwe, the secretary of Villa, also being the chairman of the club, definitely he's very anxious and putting in a lot to see. In fact, if it was possible, Mulindo is even asking if they could play that game at Chitende.
Okay, I'm quickly hope, rather, that is a faith. Big games up ahead. And, you know, some will say there's a couple of mismatches between the big boys and the smaller sides as well. But over the years, you know, the Uganda Cup offers a platform for the so-called small team. Should you expect that this time around?
I mean, you know, knockout football is knockout football. If you play your cards right, you're going to get the opportunity to knock out a big team.
Yeah.
And for me, you know, looking at the... the names of the teams in the Uganda Cup are
6 o'clock.
We have 6 o'clock, you have Chimpanzee. I mean, it's eclectic like that. And I think for me, if you look at the fact that teams like Ondo Paraka, I mean, the other
Pida
team,
Black
Pida Black Angels, they did very well in the Uganda Cup to start with.
Yeah.
I feel like, yes, it's an opportunity because, you know, one, if you're lucky enough, you find the Vipers probably thinking of the next game, their next game in the league against another team, and they field, you know, a weekend side, and you take your chance.
All right, there you go. That is the Uganda Cup for you. Round of 64. Action definitely does get returned today. Runs all the way into the weekend. That is Sunday. So plenty of games to look out for. But quickly, I am from the Uganda Cup. Now it's been confirmed that Henry Chitegenyi has dumped the club side. That is UPDF. And he's going back to his former side. That is Kansai Pascon in some of the deals that continue to happen in the January transfer window. Do remember, the market is open. And certainly some bigger moves that do get to happen as it is right about now. Henry Chitegenyi back to Kansai Pascon.
Why some headlines, I saw some headlines saying former Vipers player.
Yeah.
There was something very contradicting there. Because, you know, when you tell people former Vipers player, and then at the same time, we know he's been playing with UPDF. So I don't know what's... I don't understand the chemistry behind it.
It's
quite
prominence.
So well.
It's prominence. In headline writing, you have to go with the one that you know will catch the eye.
So you don't mind even when I play for Bull FC, but I'm...
But if you played for Arsenal, that's more important.
Just like, this youngster did, same with you, Joseph, who has now signed for Bull FC. He's been a Villa player for one season, but the headline was saying former Express player. So I don't know the idea. Anyway, I think East or West home is always the best.
Right.
And probably he tried his chance out and things have failed. And I think for him going back to Kansai Plascon is something which is quite good for him.
Mm.
And
Kansai have bounced up and down in the FIFA Big League. They've not really found that stability.
You know, I don't know. Kansai Plascon, at one point in time, it was this huge brand that everyone would think that, yes, it's the future of the next... maybe football outside these other big teams, big names, the VEC teams you talk about. But administrative issues, like we've always talked about, you can have the money, but if you don't have the people, the people who have the brain of the game. That's why we say we need so much sports administrative courses for many of these gentlemen and ladies who are managing these clubs.
Yeah.
So for me, I think for him to he's looking for market.
Mm.
One way of a player looking for market is to try to get a stable club, a club that is going to help sell him, so that in the end of it all, you see himself in one of the big clubs in the Premier League or in the region of East Africa.
All right, quickly, guys, that is the transfer window in January. So many players switching sides and pretty much looking to play a bit of football as we head into the second one. But quickly, away from that, let's talk the national football team. Yes, that is the Uganda Cranes, because it's been confirmed going into the FIFA 2022 World Cup Qatar qualifiers. The Cranes have actually been drawn in Port 2, where they are set to pretty much avoid some of the big boys, including Cote d'Ivoire. You could mention teams like former champions Zambia in there. Teams like Gabon, Benin are in their pool as well. But the interesting thing is that all the giants are definitely in Port 1. And ultimately, it's quite the tedious journey for them to play at their first ever World Cup. Because first of all, they'll need to come through a group, finish top of a group out of the 10 groups, ultimately get into the final playoff round, which will involve the home and away fixture, where the top five teams that finish in the top five places will certainly get to represent Africa at the 2022 World Cup. Faith, most of the fans are saying, we get to our first World Cup. What do you make of the polls? And us in Port 2, does that show progress for the Cranes going into the draws next Wednesday?
Of course it does show progress. And for me, you know, with where it comes to Uganda, we've been that nearly team.
Yeah.
Even the last World Cup qualifying phase, we came really close and it just, for some reason, it does not work out. I feel like this is more like a fair draw.
Mm.
If you can be in there, make sure you're amongst the 10 teams that are going to compete for those slots at the World Cup, then it's anyone's game. Because, one, Uganda, at the moment, our players have gained a lot of international experience. We've been to AFCON twice. And I proudly say that we've been to AFCON twice, and the qualifying phases that we've also been to, and we've come out on top. Even sometimes in tough circumstances, whenever we've gone to some West African countries where it's unfathomable to even get a draw, but we come back with those draws. I feel like Uganda, we are ready. This
Okay, Sharon, the interesting thing is that
you like
football,
faith so much and hope. You don't
it's
like
because,
me.
Hope it's
and
because
faith.
You know what happens is
I
always have hope on Friday for game on.
So you're,
I get used to calling her name. And since it's ladies here,
the trend
continues.
That.
But that being said, Ghana football is going places. She mentions us qualifying for back-to-back AFCONs. And on top of that, most of our players have gotten exposure in North Africa in the recent past. So in the event that we've got a North African side in our group, it should be relatively easy. But TDS, Jan, if you're going to go to the World Cup?
Well, if you look at the pool, I'm quite very certain that the pool has helped us a little bit. Because you see, being put in the pool of Ivory Coast, South Africa, and the rest is quite, it clearly tells you how big Uganda has grown. You talk about what some of the key notable players. I can talk about Emmanuel Okwi.
Yeah.
Okwi, up to today, is one of the players who moved from East Africa to North Africa, who is at least struggling to score some goals there, much as the rest are still struggling there. Patrick Henry Kadus. At the moment, as we are very excited for this, and as we wait for the draws next week, right now the Federation should be looking out, McKinsey actually should be looking out, who is going to help Okwi, because apparently we don't expect Kadu to be one of the sharp strikers as we thought probably, because his stay in the Northern Africa has clearly told us and clearly showed to us that we still yearn to get more of the strikers and to see how we. But nonetheless, Uganda is not a country right now that is struggling to look for players. We have quite a number of them. However, our giants that we face are a little bit too ahead of us. These are the countries that have many, at least two or three stars playing in Uganda Premier League, in English Premier League, or they're playing probably in the Spaniard League and other leagues, that has exposed them with a lot of facilities and the rest. But with us, our players are mostly domestic players, which is an advantage to us, because also having 90% of your players who are domestic players is also very okay, because they get acclimatized together, they get socialized together. It is very, very easy to implement your strategies you want. Two, the financial aspect has improved. You look at the government, how the government has been financing FUFA, for instance, for the past years, and it doesn't come just out of the silver plate. It's because of the work that the Federation has done. You're seeing results. Of course, much as we not won the trophy, but at least you're seeing results. Continuous progress and qualifications to AFCON is a kudos to the Federation. And it's one thing Maguga Zole has talked about. Well, we'd say, where are the trophies? But you know, football is not easy to get a trophy. We have England, we have so many countries in the world that have continuously performed at World Cup but no trophies, okay?
Yeah.
So for someone to begin judging for someone to begin judging Uganda Cranes because that we are spending so much money on them without, but we're looking at the numbers.
Yeah.
Because at the first of football brings in a lot of numbers. So for me, it's not going to be an easy journey, by the way. This one, we must put it very crystal clear here. But Faith has said something very notable here, that apparently Uganda is very able to go out there to West Africa and get results. Our result at Comoros gave us a very turning point, by the way, here at home. Even at Egypt, the game we played against the Egyptians, that goal up today, we say it is still controversial. That denied us for the World Cup qualifiers. Yeah? So regardless, I think we have learned a lesson and picked from there. And for me, I'm just waiting for the call-up.
Yeah.
The call-up will also matter a lot. The team that we are going to assemble will determine our qualification to World Cup.
Okay, finally, as we move on from this conversation, you look at our performance at the most recent AFCON, that is Cairo, Egypt. You look at some of the key players. You speak of names like Emmanuel Okwi, Abdul Malan,
the only one
Kambani.
I can talk about among the forwards at the moment.
And then the way we performed against the big boys, Egypt, Senegal, DR Congo in there as well. Should we think that, the exposure that the boys have got playing against some of these boys shows us that we can rub shoulders when we come up against them?
Man, if you look at now, like the fact that Alan has moved to Morocco, to Algeria, that situation and scenario is, tailor-made for a player like Okello. If Okello goes to Morocco and in these few months can progress as a player in leaps and bounds, and he becomes more of a world beater within, like, say, 6 months. I do not doubt Uganda's ability to go out there and, and challenge teams. Although, at the end, if you're looking at teams like, say, Ivory Coast, you're looking at a team that literally has a front three that is scary. If you're thinking of the fact that Khadija, the Aston Villa striker, who has been out for a long time,
they've
but
sent
is
him
back
out on loan to Qatar now.
Yeah, now like if you're looking at Khadija, then you're looking at Zaha.
Yes.
Left. I mean, right mid, right wing. And you're looking at Pepe left wing.
Yeah.
Pepe of us.
Do we have something that can match up to that? Do we have something that can match up to that as Uganda? I don't think so. I don't think so. But then again, I know Uganda, we are crafty. We are street smart. We are not going to just be there and roll up. I mean, the years Mitchell coached that team, there are so many things we picked up, rolling with the punches, get your one goal and, go run away with it if you must.
Okay. Me, what I think probably to a little bit, at a quick last wrap up is... one thing I know about Ugandan players, in the recent years, we have now what we call a brave heart. Because even our game against Senegal at AFCON, clearly, much as we lost, but you really see some good display of football. Yeah. Our game against DRC Congo also was very good football. We displayed, actually watched that game together, me and Faith. We literally didn't even expect, by the way, that kind of performance. That's a fact.
Mm.
But the boys gave us a shock of our life while we were watching from, and Ugandans are like, what? So I think our qualifications beyond the group stages alone is a very good impetus and a very good career to us. I know, of course, the Pepe Kales will come if we are grown against them in the same group. And I love calling him Pepe Kale, really. I'm sorry. But they would want to try to prove to us that, we are the giants, we are everything. But then again, it's always so good to be under. Even the Bible says, blessed is the person who is underlooked for the kingdom of God.
We are now quoting the Bible.
Okay. All right, guys, we've got to get into a short break now. But we come back after the break. Tell you what, there is a Tanzania that should be playing in the Premier League. That is Mbwana Samata crossing over from Belgium. That is from the club side. That is Kara Seagang. So when we come back after the break, he signed a 4.5-year deal with the club side. That is Aston Villa. Also after the break, the first Grand Slam over. Yes, the Australian Open is currently underway. It's still round one. Some of the big names have progressed into the next round. Plus football in the Premier League and certainly the Copa del Rey as well. So we'll be right back after the break. You're watching Game On and you're probably powered by 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports.
Game On. It's brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.